There are two main features that are exclusive to UMotion professional users: the animation importer and the constraint system. With the animation importer, you can import any existing animations, whether being a motion captured animation or an animation created in a third-party modeling application. That way, you can use UMotion to fine-tune existing animations directly in the scene where the animation is going to be used. The constraint system is a powerful collection of components that provides advanced features. The currently implemented constraints are the inverse kinematics, child off, and custom property constraint. The inverse kinematics constraint greatly reduces your effort to create animations. It allows you to directly manipulate the endpoint of a bone chain without manipulating each and every single bone. Inverse kinematics also has great advantages in situations where body parts need to stay exactly in place, like in a climbing animation. It's worth noting though that forward kinematics also has its advantages in some situations. That's why UMotion uses two rigs, one for forward kinematics and one for inverse kinematics. That way, you can easily blend between both rigs, allowing you to combine the power of both approaches. By combining multiple inverse kinematics constraints, you can create advanced rigs just as you would do in your favorite 3D modeling application. With the child off constraint, you can change the parent of any joint or transform during an animation. Like in a reload animation, where the magazine is first attached to the player's hand and then attached to the gun. The custom property constraint is like a remote control. It links to existing properties of one or multiple bones. This is not only useful when you want to give existing properties more speaking names, but also gives you the possibility to control the animation of multiple bones from a single control bone.